Okay, so with that, we've covered a lot. How do we tie all of this together? Well, in general, I see tokenomic talent being hired to attend to three distinct areas of concern: design and development, monitoring and management, and tokenized finance. Let's drill down into these tasks and the tools required for each of them. For design and development, the expert will be hired to design or engineer systems that leverage blockchain in some way that creates or improves a business or an economic process. There are going to be some substantial differences in how this work is done, generally driven by the degree of centralization that characterizes the economic process being modeled. Centralized systems can generally be adequately modeled in spreadsheets, inheriting many of the methods and best practices used in conventional financial modeling and management accounting. Decentralized systems will probably require more complex agent-based modeling using machinations, Python, or some other programming-based tool, although some very, very early stage prototypes may get by with spreadsheets as well. Whichever case it happens to be, real-world data needs to be integrated into the modeling as soon as possible, either through the use of known industry benchmarks, relevant real-world data, or with the use of live user testing to make sure that we're not just engaging in sheer make-believe with this exercise. You will also need to draw on research about the latest tokenomic designs and mechanisms and to be able to evaluate your own designs within a competitive context as well. You may also need some good writing skills to contribute to white paper write-ups on tokenomics for your project. For monitoring and management in early testing and operations, you're probably going to need a data science stack in R or Python, maybe machinations, and an analytics tool like Power BI or Tableau. So you're going to need to be able to define and measure and comprehend key performance indicators for users and the organization that's tasked with the management and maintenance of this system. You'll then need to read these KPIs to perform ongoing tuning and balancing, or perhaps to provide input on new features and structural change requests and requirements. Finally, in the case of tokenized financing, the most common task to crack will be an initial fundraising. The token sale format has remained largely unchanged since 2017 and can be wholly and adequately modeled within a spreadsheet environment. Awareness and experience of VC investing and or corporate finance can also be helpful to you in this area. You're also going to need to be able to conduct research to be aware of what recent deals have been closing in the market, what profile the projects had, and what investors they had. You're also going to need to come to a view of what upcoming market conditions could mean for how the offer is reviewed and received by the public and the investors. Tokenomics expertise may also be sought to calibrate the deployment of large token-funded reward campaigns or larger over-the-counter deals used to secure special partnerships as the project develops. All of these assessments will benefit from a broader understanding of exchange markets and liquidity more generally. And so with that, we conclude our epic inquiry into the realm of tokenomics. I initially went for a broad definition, saying that it's concerned with the design, analysis, and management of economic systems and processes built with blockchain technology, and that we have more to gain by looking at tokenomics through the lens of economic theory rather than current blockchain norms and applications to inform the scope and methodology for this field. We then went on to discuss how tokenomics intersects and reshapes various concerns in business administration and management, noting strong implications for revenue and treasury management in particular. Finally, we looked at tools and methods that are specifically applied to address tokenomic problems and how they vary between different use cases. So I hope this has been a helpful and thorough introduction to the field and shows you that there are lots of opportunities and areas for you to get involved with that benefit from a range of professional backgrounds and experiences and a variety of aptitudes and skills.